I'm John Prakash Vegas, assistant professor from AJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. And I'm going to discuss about data mining and data warehousing module 3. So in this module, I'm going to discuss about association analysis, problem definition, frequent item set generation, rule generation. And in the subsequent lectures, I'm also going to discuss about alternative methods for generating frequent item sets, FP growth algorithm, evaluation of association patterns. So first we'll see about market basket analysis. If you are going for a supermarket, we may purchase various items, milk, bread, eggs, or various items are purchased by various customers. And as a market analyst, we can find some correlation among the various transactions done by the customers. And frequent item set mining will lead to discover these association and correlation among the items in a large transactional relational data set. And many business entrepreneurs will accumulate these large quantities of data from their day-to-day operation. Maybe a supermarket or grocery store stores the transactions done by their customers. And here we can see that this transaction may be represented as a relational database. Transaction ID with the items purchased. And here the retailers can find some interesting patterns, and also customers' behavior, how they are purchasing the various items, they can analyze. The association analysis is a methodology which is useful for discovering interesting relationships hidden in large data set. And these association analysis may be represented as association rules, or which is also called as sets of frequent items. The association rules are written as a item, frequent items in the left hand side and frequent items in the right hand side. And what is the association between the items? Now here the rule suggests that there is a strong relationship between sales of a diaper and a sale of a beer, because many customers have purchased diaper, they are also purchased the beer. This association analysis is also applicable in other domains like bioinformatics, medical diagnosis, web mining, scientific data analysis, etc. And this market basket data can be represented as a binary format, binary 0-1 format, where we are representing each row corresponding to a transaction and each column corresponding to an item. If an item is present, then we are representing as a 1. And the item is not present, then we are choosing as a 0. So here we are writing as a 0. And there is a transaction 3 where milk and diaper and beer is purchased. That's why this is represented as a 1. And remaining all items are represented as a 0. The item set and support count can be formally defined as a, let I is equal to I1, I2 till ID be a list of items in a market basket data, and T equal to T1, T2 till TN be a set of all transactions. Each transaction TI contains a subset of items chosen from this item I. In association analysis, a collection of 0 or more items is termed as a item set. If an item set contains K items, that is called as a K item set. For example, in the market basket data, beer, diaper, milk, Here three items are purchased, and this will form a three item set. Now association rule mining, given a set of transactions, find the rules that will predict the occurrence of the items based on the occurrence of other items in the transaction. For example, given one association rule, if diaper is purchased, what is the chance that, or what is the possibility that the customer is going to purchase beer? Or one more rule, association rule, milk and bread is purchased, what is the chance that X and Coke is also purchased? So like this, we can predict the occurrence of an item if certain items are present in the transaction. Now let us see some of the definitions. A item set is a collection of one or more items. Now here we can see one example. Milk, bread and diaper is an item set, which is a three item set, because there are three items are present in the item set. Now support, which is represented as sigma, which is a frequency of occurrence of an item set in a transaction. Here there is a transaction, five transactions are given, and what is the occurrences of milk, bread and diaper? So milk bread diaper, which is occurred in the transaction ID 4 and transaction ID 5. That's why the support count is 2. Support, the fraction of transactions that contain an item set. For example, the support of milk, bread and diaper, the support of this item set is equal to support count 2 and divided by total number of transactions, that is 5, 2 by 5. Frequent item set, an item set whose support is greater than or equal to minimum support threshold. If we are setting some minimum threshold support value, and the item sets whose support is greater than or equal to minimum support threshold, then they are called as a frequent item set. And next we are going to discuss about association rule. An implication expression of the form X implies Y, where X and Y are the item set. For example, milk diaper implies beer, means if the customers are purchasing milk and diaper, there also possibility that there is they also purchase beer. And in order to evaluate these rules, there are two metrics are used. One is support, as we discussed earlier, that is a fraction of transactions that contain both X and Y, that is milk, diaper and beer, which is existing in a transaction, so divided by the total number of transactions. Similarly, confidence. In what confidence we can say that this rule can be applicable? So this is a measure how often items in Y appear in a transaction that contain X. So in what level of confidence we can say that this rule can be applied? For example, the association rule, milk, diaper and beer. So S is equal to support. So support is given by support count, milk, diaper and beer, which is occurring twice in this transaction set, divided by total number of transactions, that is 2 by 5, which is equal to 0.4. Similarly, the confidence, which is equal to the support. So support, that is milk, diaper and beer, which is occurring 2 times in this, and also the left hand side item set, milk and diaper. How many times it is occurring? Milk and diaper, milk and diaper, milk diaper occurring thrice. That's why, which is 2 by 3, which is equal to 0.67. So we have 67% confidence that this particular customer, those who are buying milk and diaper, is also going to purchase beer. If you are formally saying the same association rule in a formal way, the rule A implies B holds in a transaction set D with support S, where S is a percentage of transactions in D that contain both the item sets, union of items A union B, which is also taken as a probability, probability of A union B. And the rule A implies B as a confidence C in the transaction set D, where C is a percentage of transaction in D containing A that also contain in B. So which we can say as a conditional probability, probability of B given A. Now support, we can represent it as a P A union B. The confidence we can say P probability of B, conditional probability B given A. The confidence A implies B, which is equal to probability of B given A, which is equal to support of A union B divided by support of A. So that is equal to support count of A union B. So both left hand side and right hand side, both values, support count divided by support count in the only left hand side, support count of A. The rules that satisfy both minimum support threshold and minimum confidence threshold are called as a strong rules. So for a given transaction, if you are already setting some minimum support threshold value and minimum confidence threshold value, then those transactions which are supporting this rule are called as a strong or frequently item sets. Now given in this mining association rule, there are 5 transactions as shown in the table. And the examples of rules will be milk and diaper implies beer. So the support count is, first we need to compute milk and diaper and beer. How many times it is shown? Milk, diaper, beer. So occurrence is here milk, diaper, beer. Together the occurrence is milk, diaper and beer. One, then milk, diaper, beer, two, milk, okay, two. So, two by total number of transactions, that is 5. 2 by 5 is 20 by, so 2 by 5 is 0.4. Then, confidence, that is milk, diaper and beer, how many times it is occurring? So milk, diaper and beer, which is occurring 2 times, divided by left hand side milk and diaper, which is occurring, milk and diaper once, milk, diaper twice, milk, diaper thrice. So 2 by 3, which is equal to 0.67. So 2 by 3, 0.666, that is we can compute as a 0.67. Similarly, milk, beer. So we need to compute milk and beer. What is the confidence? What is the support and what is the confidence? But the observation is that all the above rules are binary patterns of the same item set, milk, diaper, beer. So rules originating from the same item set have identical support but can have different confidence. Here the support is identical but confidence level may differ. So that's why there is a need to decouple or separate the support and confidence requirements. So, in association rule mining task, the given set of transaction T, the goal of association rule mining is to find all the rules having support which is greater than or equal to minimum support threshold and confidence which is greater than or equal to minimum confidence threshold. And there are various approaches are there. So one is brute force approach, where we list all the possible association rules, then we are computing the support and confidence of each rules. Then again we are filtering the rules or prune the rules which fails the minimum support and minimum confidence. So here this is a computationally intensive type of job, because brute force approach is every possible rule we need to list, we need to compute the support, confidence. If the database is very large, then it is very complex and computationally it is very difficult, or which is a time consuming task. And so mining association rules, there are two different steps are there. The first step is frequent item set generation. Generate all item sets whose support is greater than or equal to minimum support. And second is rule generation. We need to generate the rule, generate high confidence rules for each frequent item set, where each rule is a binary partitioning of a frequent item set. So that we are going to discuss in the next class. So thank you for listening the lecture.